Spurs were able to pull together for a 130-102 win tonight.
The Spurs had five players scoring in double digits, including Kawhi Leonard and Tim Duncan, 17 points apiece, but in the end it was not enough for a win.
According to the Texas State Police Department records, 27 public intoxication arrests have already been made this year. A major online security vulnerability called Heartbleed has been discovered, putting a lot of internet users' personal information at risk. There is no simple fix to the problem.
Public intoxication is a Class C misdemeanor, but due to the nature of a PI, police can spend up to an hour booking an individual for an offense. Texas State Police Captain Daniel Benitez says that decriminalizing PIs could be a good thing, but worries that the number of offenses could go up if there's no punishment.
Some of the downfalls is that people won't maybe take their consequences lightly. In other words, they feel that they can go out and do whatever they want and not have to suffer any consequences for their actions.
I mean, it takes more cops' time and it takes more tax dollars, so that's things that that they won't have to spend on anymore, which is good, but also then people will know that they're not going to get punished for their actions.
Texas State freshman Matthew Hubble has dealt with a PI charge firsthand and thinks decriminalization is the way to go.
After I was released, I still had to deal with it, you know? I still had the arrest and the charges over my shoulder, even though I was released from the jail.
By decriminalizing public intoxication, offenders would be free to leave the center without any repercussions after they've sobered up.
The PI charge is just so that they're not causing harm to themselves and not causing harm to others. So I feel like just taking them out and putting them in a center is going to take them away from any kind of danger they could cause to anybody else.
According to the Texas State Police Department records, 27 public intoxication arrests have already been made this year.
That number doesn't include San Marcos PD arrests. For Bobcat Update, I'm Caitlin Duane. College is one of the last times that a high concentration of men and women can be found working together in the same place. The term MRS degree was coined in the 40s and is used to describe women who attend college to meet their soulmates.
A lot of girls are taught by their parents that you're going to grow up, you're going to go to school, but you're going to get married. And like getting married is the most important part of that scenario. But I would hope that girls today are thinking sort of beyond that.
The Federal Department of Education recently released statistics that show women are more likely than men to receive bachelor degrees, and women, on average, have higher GPAs. Texas State junior Rebecca Feltner says women don't go to college just to meet somebody.
I feel you need to go to college, get a degree, to not be able to rely on a man.
The median age for a woman to get married for the first time is 27, often many years after graduation. Sociology professor Kelly Mosel says it's better for college-age women to focus on themselves and plan for their financial security rather than worrying about getting a ring or a new last name.
I want them to go into a profession. If you want to have somebody who you're in a serious relationship with, that's fine, but that's the goal, is for you to be an independent, successful woman. And you can still be married, but you still have to be those things.
For Bobcat Update, I'm Caitlin Duane.
Texas U.S. Senator Ted Cruz is supporting fellow Republican Connie Burton in her run for state Senate. Cruz traveled to Fort Worth yesterday, where Burton is campaigning to replace Wendy Davis. Davis is the Democratic nominee for Texas governor. Cruz is a potential candidate for president in 2016. Yesterday, a website pushing for 1 million signatures to support Cruz for president went online. Cruz, though, says he's not ready to commit to a presidential campaign. Saying he was his first choice today, the Celtics general manager, Danny Ainge, introduced Brad Stevens as the new head coach of the Boston Celtics. At 36 years of age, Stevens now becomes the youngest coach in the NBA after leading the Butler Bulldogs. A group of Texas anti-abortion activists are taking their message to students by protesting in front of Fort Worth high schools. The activists say they are preaching the gospel as they hand out literature against abortion. Parents and students say that some of the pictures and books are inappropriate and that the group is being too aggressive. Fort Worth school officials say they can't do anything about it because the group is on a public sidewalk and have a right to free speech. Some parents are making petitions against the group and are looking for ways to stop them.